Okay guys, so today I'm switching it up a little bit and doing an EDC tag video. And this EDC tag video I thought would be a pretty interesting idea. And as always guys, before we get into this, please do not forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe to my channel, and please make sure to check out the channels linked in the description below, or the tag channels I'm going to be checking out, and let them know that I sent you their way. So for the video, as I always do before I get into the people I've tagged, this video is going to be talking about the knives that I EDC, honestly EDC, the most. And I think this is a really interesting video, or I thought it might be really interesting, because as a YouTube reviewer and just as a knife lover, I have a lot of different knives, and I have a lot of different nice knives. I mean, I have this Benchmade 761. This is actually a first production run 761 by Benchmade. It's a very expensive, really nice knife. I have things like Microtech Ultratex. I have Chris Reeves knives, Sebenzas, and you know, a whole bunch of really nice knives to EDC and a really great selection to choose from. But what do I honestly find myself carrying the most? And I wanted to do this video because, one, I want to see other people's top kind of EDC choice, and I want to share with you guys what kind of knives that, when I'm not carrying knives to test and review, what honestly finds their way into my pocket the most. And I have two here because it's kind of a little bit of a tie, but hopefully most people just select one, but one to two knives that we honestly EDC the most. And so my top one that I EDC the most, and it's because I've kind of had this knife, not this exact version, but I've had the Benchmade 556 mini grip for a very long time. I actually had a black handled one. Now I have a blue handled version of the same knife. And this is probably my top most EDC knife because it's such a great size for being able to fit into pretty much any circumstance or situation. It's very tough, and it's also a very good knife for being a knife. It has a really, really sharp edge on it out of box, and the grind and overall profile that Benchmade puts on these knives makes them a very capable all-arounder knife. You can do everything from dressing small game animals to opening packages very easily. And another thing about this knife is it's a very non-aggressive and non-obtrusive looking knife. It looks, unless you get it in a really flamboyant handle color like I did, it's actually a really good knife at just kind of blending in. It's almost kind of, the Griptilian series is kind of what you would consider like to be your Toyota Camry and Corolla. Like the mini grips are kind of like the Toyota Corolla of the knife world. They're not super expensive, they're not super cheap, but they're not super expensive. They're very reliable. They don't necessarily do anything super awesome. There's no carbon fiber and titanium and wild stuff on them, but they do their job as a knife really well. So I kind of think of them as like the Toyota slash Corolla, or sorry, Camry slash Corolla of the knife world. So this knife is a really good daily carry, and it's my top carry because when I had my black one, I haven't carried this blue one as much as the black one, but when I had my black one, I carried it a lot, and I still find myself actually carrying this blue one quite a bit. And I did actually like this updated color because the black one was cool and all, but this blue was really a nice spice, and it looks pretty awesome, I think. It's a nice differential between the black. So that's my first most carried knife, and I do find myself, honestly, I find this in my pockets quite frequently and rocked with a deep carry clip, whether it's the Adamus or this is the Bug Out clip, or the deep carry clip that's on the Bug Out. I find myself EDCing this knife a surprising amount. So the next one is the Zero Tolerance 0452, and this is in the carbon fiber. And this is another one that, while it's a little bit big and people might not be expecting it, I actually find myself carrying this one a lot because, one, it's very lightweight. Two, its action is amazing. I really love the action on this knife. It's a really fun knife to just kind of sit there and play with. and open and open and open because the action is so nice and so smooth on this knife. And thirdly, it is a really good knife for doing everyday carry tasks. It has a very good steel S35VN, and so you don't really have to worry about the steel losing its edge through daily tasks. And the other thing is that the overall blade profile makes it good for just doing opening things, cutting things, and just doing the different tasks that you need to do with a knife on an everyday level. And as well, it also is nice because you can push it into a tactical role pretty easily. And so I like having this kind of dual role that this knife can serve in being a tactical slash everyday carry knife. Plus, it also looks very nice. It looks very elegant, and once again, it's very lightweight too, especially for its size being considered. So those are my top two, honestly, EDC most knives, and they're knives that are really great, really easy to carry in my opinion, and overall real joy to carry, especially the ZT0452, because I really like the way it looks. I love that carbon fiber scale on it. It looks really nice. It looks pretty high end. And the other thing is that price points on both of these knives is not super high. You know, it's like when you start carrying knives like the 761 here, this is a $400 plus knife. And so you kind of get a little bit antsy about wanting to carry something this expensive on a daily level, because it's like, wow, it's a lot of money to have just sitting in your pocket. And so there is kind of a nice thing about carrying some of these more mildly expensive knives. This one's around anywhere from $65 to $90. And this one, you know, is around $150 to $220, depending whether you get it used or new. And so you can get them for, you know, a good amount of money. They're not super expensive, but they're not super cheap either. Anyways, so now onto the people I tag. The first one I'm going to tag, and I'm going to roll in pictures of the different channels just as I normally do with tag videos. And the first one's going to be Cedric Ada. He does a lot of EDC content, and him and I have gone back and forth. If you guys are familiar with the channel before, we've done collaborations before, and so we're kind of friends, and we definitely know each other, and so I kind of like to tag him whenever I can. And then the next one is Zelric, and I've been watching his channel for some time. I really like, he does a lot of unique knives. He hits some of the knives, some of the best tech Wii kind of knives that go under the radar of most knife companies, or not companies, sorry, reviewers on YouTube. And so I kind of like his channel for that reason. Also, another one who's similar and is also being tagged is Aaron's EDC Reviews. Like Zelric, he also does a lot of the knives like the Kaiser Megatherium and some of the knives that are more lesser known out there that are really nice knives. I mean, I personally had a Megatherium myself, so I can say that it was a pretty nice knife. I did sell it off, but it was a pretty nice knife, and so really cool. Those two are really cool. And then lastly is Gearnut, and Gearnut just does a whole bunch of different EDC things, everything from sharpening different sharpening pieces of kit to different knives out there, and Leathermans, multi-tools, and stuff like that. So he does a whole bunch of different knife, gear, EDC content, just a whole bunch of stuff. So he's more of a mixed bag. Anyways, those are the four primary YouTubers I'm tagging, and hopefully you guys will go check out their channel. Like I said in the beginning of this video, their links will be in the description below. So if you guys want to go check out their videos or their content overall, that will be them. And I'm really curious overall to what they have to say for their most EDC knives, especially Cedric Ada, because he goes through a lot of knives. If you guys don't really know, he does a lot of edge retention tests, which requires him having a huge basis of knives. So I'm really curious to see what his kind of most EDC knife is, because he has seemingly a whole bunch of knives to choose from that are all, once again, really nice knives that use really high-end materials. And when you start to get into these knives that use a lot of high-end materials, it's like, which S35VN folder am I going to carry today? It gets a little bit challenging. I know it's like first world problems, right? But I am curious. So anyways, guys, that's all for now. God bless, and I'm out.